don't make any noise. So if we come to the, we will come later to the spherical one. We have a cube of size 1 meter. What will be its surface area?
1.
Surface area will be area of each face into 6. It has 6 faces, so it is area of each face into 6. So that is 6 meter square.
Okay.
If this 1 meter area, 1 meter of this, it is broken into 2. Into 2. That is halved at the center. This was 1, I break it apart. So that means I have cut it at the center. So I have cut it at the center. So what will happen? The area will now change. The overall volume will remain same, but the surface area will change. And obviously, it will be, there are surfaces which are of 1 meter each, but some surfaces are half. But they are, now they are twice. So if I have broken it, so this face, 1, is half, the back face is half, okay? So these, so we have 2 blocks. We have 2 blocks with each block has how many faces of 1 meter?
3.
I think there will be 2 faces.
1, 2,
1,
and 3 half. 2 and 4 half.
2 into 1 meter plus 4 into
4 into half meter.
0.5 meter square. 0.5 into 0.5 actually. So that means if I calculate this surface area, it is 4 pi r square. Sorry, not 4 pi, sorry. So the surface area, if you calculate from here, it will be clearly greater than the original one. So now if you break it further into more pieces, more small elements, the surface area will increase. Now coming to the spherical one, if we have spherical one, we have area is 4 pi r square and volume is 4 by 3 pi r cube. If I take the ratio, it is surface area to volume. So what will be it? So it gives us surface area over volume is equal to 3 by r. Okay, so which is, it gives us surface area is 3 by r times the volume. 3 by r times the volume. It means that the surface area to volume ratio is large. So for a nanostructure or a nanoparticle, surface area to volume ratio is large. This is one of the important property of the nanostructures. Now what will do this surface area to volume ratio? Why it is important? What is surface energy? Don't make noise. Who is making noise? Surface energy. We have gases, we have liquids, we have solids. Out of these, which one has the largest surface energy? Out of these, which one has the largest surface energy? Anybody?
Gases.
What is surface energy?
फ्री एनर्जी होती है सर
किसकी
पार्टिकल
की शाबाश फ्री एनर्जी उससे क्या होगा व्हाट डज दिस फ्री एनर्जी एग्जैक्टली मीन सो वी कैन डिफाइन द सरफेस एनर्जी can be defined as the energy to put an atom on the surface. There are other definitions as well. I will tell them later on. So this is one of the definition that surface energy is that of energy which is required to put an atom on the surface of a particle or a material. So obviously for gases it doesn't make any sense because they, the relative distances between the atoms of the gases is very large.
Solid.
So therefore there is very less interaction between them, so that energy is very small as compared to those liquids and gases. And atoms in any case, whether it is solid, whether it is liquid, whether it is gas, atoms lower their energies by forming a surface. So atoms lower their energies by forming a surface. Because gases don't have any surfaces, they do not form surfaces, so it may be a liquid or solid. So they form this energy by forming a liquid or a solid. That means if we have particles in the gas, the energies as you increase they move apart from each other, and this is the formation energy, not the surface energy. This is the formation energy. So gases, the solids are here. They lower their energies. This will be a liquid or a solid. And in gases, they do not combine it easily at ambient conditions. So we can think of, if this is the solids here, they can form their particular surfaces. So they form a particular structure in which the surface atoms have high energies due to incomplete bonding at surface. This is important point. So in the case of a surface, whether it is a solid or a liquid surface, so this is the, these are the surface atoms here, but when you move inside, these are the bulk atoms which are beneath the surface. These are called bulk atoms here. Similarly here, so if you see the atom which is at this point, or the atom which is at here in the center of this surface, in the material, at the bulk of the material, the energy of this atom here is much larger because it has now much tendency to react to any other species rather than this in the bulk. So in that sense, we are saying that this surface atom has higher surface energy due to this incomplete bonding. Because it is incomplete bonding, so it will lower its energy by combining with any other material, with any other reactive material, reactive atoms. Okay, so that means those atoms which are at the surface, they have high energies due to incomplete bonding at the surface of a liquid or a solid. This high energy state is actually measured. We are measuring this energy as with respect to this energy at the bulk, at the interior of the material. Now, this is one case. Another thing is that the surface atoms wants to minimize that energy. Minimize it is area actually, which give rise to surface tension. So at the same time, those atoms which are at the surface, they will try to minimize their area. And this is the simple case of forming of a liquid drop, that surface tension. So we have two terms here, surface energy and surface tension. Surface energy is written as gamma and surface tension is written as sigma. Dimensionally, if you take the dimensions of those two, they are same. Dimensionally they are same, but physically they are different. Physically, they are different.
Sir, repeat.
Okay. Surface tension. So, I say that the surface atoms, they will like to minimize their surface area. One is the surface energy, which is higher for the surface atoms. And there is another property with that surface atoms. That means they will try to minimize their area by forming the bonding actually. Because they will try to form the bond with the atoms which are near to them, to the neighbor atoms, and when they try to form those bonds, in that case they will try to minimize the area of the surface, and due to that minimization, surface tension will arise. Surface tension is actually denoted by sigma, and it is defined as force per unit general length okay. And this gamma is energy per unit area. If you calculate their dimensions, this becomes energy upon area, which is joule upon meter square, which is newton meter square, which is newton upon meter This is what. If you calculate this, this is force upon length. So this is Newton. Sorry, I have done it reverse. Sorry. There is. This is the length. This is the force upon area. So dimensionally they are identical, but physically they are different, since this gamma, that is a surface energy, is a scalar quantity. And what is surface tension? It is in second order tensor.
Which minimizes the area?
Because of minimization of area, surface tension arises.
Yes, sir. Surface tension means area to come.
When it tries to minimize its area and it minimizes to minimize its dimensions, actually. The general term is dimension. So that gives rise to it as surface tension. And it is a tensor, actually. Surface tension is a tensor, that gamma is a scalar quantity, which is surface energy. In case of liquids, if we have liquids, both gamma and sigma, they are identical throughout the surface of the liquid, throughout the liquid. They are same in all directions of the liquid surface. They are identical, actually. But in case of solids, these are anisotropic. Anisotropic means the values differ, actually. Tensor, what does tensor mean? Tensor means that it has a particular value in a particular direction. So these become anisotropic. That means different values in different directions. Another important point is that for solids, solids have another property, that they possess definite arrangement of atoms, that is order, long range order for crystalline. They may be also amorphous, that is when we have short range order. So it is important that to define sigma and gamma for a solid by the density, particle density, plus lattice constant. So we need a density and a lattice constant for defining the surface energy and the surface tension in case of solids. But for liquids, the density is N. So what happens in nanoparticles, actually, in nanomaterials or nanostructures? So what happens this? Different number of atoms actually characterizes a nanoparticle. So what is the size of atoms actually in a nanoparticle or a nanocluster actually? Those are sometimes called as clusters, nanoclusters, a group of atoms like this. So will be one cluster, then there will be another cluster. And I have sent you book. If you have gone through the first chapter of that book, you might have seen some caught up that is called magic numbers. Magic numbers are some of the numbers of atoms which make those nanoclusters stable. That's a given number of atoms is there, and those number of atoms make a given nanocluster stable. When we increase this number, when we increase the number of those atoms in a particular given nanocluster, the energy values, the every parameter, it approaches its bulk value. Bulk value means that when its size was large, but when it is at smaller values, the size is very small. The surface to volume ratio is large, as we have discussed in the beginning of this class, that surface to volume ratio, it is large. Hence, the equilibrium shape, equilibrium shape means that means when all the atoms have settled at their minimum energies, and all the atoms of the cluster of a nanoparticles, they have attained their position of minimum energies, that becomes its equilibrium shape. And this can be attained quickly due to less number of atoms, due to large surface area. So they may find a large area and they will combine quickly with each other. And it is observed that decreasing particle size will increase surface energy, because surface area is large. So the energy of those particles, which those are maximum, because we are making it smaller and smaller. So as compared to bulk, that means since we are making it smaller, so the number of atoms which are at the center of that particular cluster are less as compared to the number of atoms which are at the surface. That is how the surface to volume ratio becomes large. So when you decrease the size of the particle, that surface area becomes large. So the particle atoms at the surface, they are large. Their surface energies are large. So decreasing particle size will increase the surface energy. It will increase the surface energy as compared to their bulk counterparts. And this makes them highly reactive, because if this is a cluster, there are less number of atoms which are in the interior of this atom as compared to which are at the surface. So the surface area for this to volume a ratio, that becomes large. And these more number of atoms which are at the surface, they become highly then reactive. And I can give a simple application, practical application. If you take a solid, ice cube and drop it into a water, warm water, then you take the same cube and crush it, then drop it into the warm water, which will be more cold quickly in less time, which will have greater effect. Crushed one. So this will one. This has more effect as compared to this, because these particles, because we are making them small, so they will react quickly. They will combine quickly with the water and they will make it more cooler in shorter time than the solid ones, because surface atoms possess more energies than bulk atoms. There is a general and empirical formula empirical formula or an equation, which is called Kelvin equation. We will not go into derivation of this, just to give an idea. Kelvin equation, it's called Kelvin equation, where we calculate actually PS by P naught. I will tell you everything. What is this about? Exponential of 4 gamma m, it is rho P R T on, and this dm. Gamma is the surface energy here. So you can calculate gamma from this equation. This is called Kelvin equation. This T on, this, it is called onset temperature when it is heated at or some particular temperature at which the nanoparticle is formed. So this is called onset temperature. This T naught of evaporation or when it is formed. Onset. Yeah, it is onset temperature at which it forms, starts to form those nanoparticles. So dm is actually the particle size, size of the nanoparticle which is formed. M is the molecular weight. This m is the molecular weight, and this rho p is the particle mass density. This mass density, this rho. R is the gauge constant, and this gamma is the surface energy. Now this ps, this is the vapor pressure of particle. This P naught is the vapor pressure of plane surface. This is the gauge constant here, R. Yes.
Sir, kya matlab plane surface?
Plane surface means that it is the vapor pressure at the surface of that particular atom, particular particle, particular structure. So if you see the relation from here, you can see this gamma and dm. What is the relation? Inverse. That is the only option, then they can be multiplied in the same term. This gamma and dm. So when they are inverse to each other, then they can be multiplied by each other. So they have an inverse relation between each other. For example, I will give you an example. If you take a silver nanoparticle, free nanoparticle, free nanoparticle, it is free energy, is surface energy is 7.2 joule per meter square, and its bulk value is 1.0 to 1.5 joule per meter square. This is for bulk in case of silver nanoparticles. So it is large. And similarly for cadmium, so it is 2.5 for case of cadmium selenium for a free nanoparticle. And it is for bulk, it is 0.75 joule per meter square. There has been given a reason, the reason that the increase in gamma increases gamma is actually, it is called as weak dilation of the in the conclusion. We can remember that as particle size decreases, the gamma increases. Dm is the particle size. Actually, M refers to, they have represented by a metal, so you can represent generally by D. So for a particle size, as you lower it, the surface energy of the particles are a cluster, particles of a cluster, that will increase. this is one point, that is surface energy. Now, surface energy is important when we discuss the melting point, because what is the surface energy, what is the cohesive energy, it will determine the melting point of the system of the system of particles. So what happens to the melting point of the nanoparticles?